So I'll be using Botpress to create my first chatbot. So Botpress is a website where you can create your first chatbot very easily. So let's go to their website. Their website is botpress.com, and once you go to their website, it's very easy to do the registration. You can click on this sign up and then you should be able to do that. But since I've already signed in, what I'll do, I'll directly go and do the login. So I'll click and I'm logging with my username and password. And once I'm logged in, this is the place where I'll be creating my first chatbot. So for doing that, what I will do, I'll click on this create bot. And this is a name that will come up automatically, but you can always change and give your own name. But for the time being, I'm just going ahead with the name they provided and click on create. And then Botpress will create the first bot automatically. So looks like my chatbot has created and it's asking me to open in studio. So what I'll do, I'll go and click on open in studio. And here they have multiple templates, but I will recommend that you always start from scratch so that you know what are the different elements which you can use in the bot. So I'll click on start from scratch and then click on use this template. And then it's loading the bot as you can see in the screen. And my bot is ready. And here you have an option called edit main flow. So click on that. And here you have your bot ready. The first thing that I'll do, I'll delete all the elements. I don't need all of them, so I'm deleting all node. So with that, I have only two node. One is start node, another is the end node. And in between start node and end node, this is where I'm going to create my own bot. So here, I'm going to create my first node. So for that, I'll click on this section and bring the standard node. And in the standard node, what I'm going to do, I am going to ask for an input from the user. So what my bot will do, my bot will probably ask, how can I help you? And then I need to put my question and bot is going to give me the answer back. So here in the add cart, the moment I click, these are the different elements that will come up on the left section. So what I will do under capture information, I will took the option called raw input. So I'll bring it here. So here, type the value to extract and here the question to ask the user. So here, what I'm going to ask my chatbot, the moment my chatbot will initiate, it will ask, hello, how can I help you today? So that's the question my chatbot is going to ask initially. And then based on that, when the question will be asked, definitely I'm expecting my user will give me some answer. This is what I'm looking for. So I'm going to store the user query in a variable. So this is a store result. So I'm going to store the query in a variable called user question. User question is a variable which is going to store the user input. So now connect this one from here to here and from here to here. So my bot is ready, but this is a very basic bot. So let's test that. For testing that, here on the right side, you will find an option called test your bot. So let's click on that. And immediately the answer came, hello, how can I help you? So let's put a question like, how is the weather looking today in Canada? And then my bot ended because there is nothing happening. This standard node is going to ask the question and then capture the user input, but taking no action. But that's not what we want. What we want is basically, we want, based on the question being asked by the user, I want the answer to come up. And the answer can come up from multiple places. So that's what the places from where the answer will come up is called the knowledge base. So now if I click here, this is called the knowledge base. So here I can create my own knowledge or I can add different elements which will provide the answer to the user input. Let's create my own knowledge base. To do that, here you'll find there is an option on the left side called knowledge base. Here you can add elements in the default knowledge base or you can create your own knowledge base. For the timing, I'm creating my own knowledge base. So I'll click on new knowledge base and here let's give it a name as technical Potpourri and click on save. Once the knowledge base is ready, what you can do, you can add multiple elements inside this knowledge base. You can add a website, you can add a document, you can add a table, you can do a web search, you can do rich text, you can do a lot of things. And basically, whatever you will do, whatever you will add, the content inside that will become your knowledge. And when user will ask for a question, this knowledge will be used to fetch the answer and provide the answer back to the user. So for the time being, let's take a very basic example. What I have done is that I have created my own knowledge base. So let me bring my terminal here. So here I have created a text file called harrypotter.txt. And inside that harrypotter.txt, I have provided some information about the Harry Potter, like who is the Harry Potter, who wrote the Harry Potter novel, who is Harry Potter's father, who is Harry Potter's mother, and who killed Harry Potter's mother and father. Very basic information, right? And I stored that information in a text file called harrypotter.txt. Okay, now I can bring that harrypotter.txt inside this knowledge base. But before bringing the knowledge base, I just want to show you when there is no knowledge about Harry Potter, if I ask the question about Harry Potter to my bot, how my bot will behave. Let's say, who is Harry Potter? This is a question I'm asking my bot, and definitely there is no content match because my chat knowledge base has no information about the Harry Potter. So that's why there is nothing response is coming back for my query, for my user query. So what I'm going to do here is that I'm going to make my chatbot intelligent. And how can I do that? I just adding that harrypotter.txt file, which I just showed you a few minutes back, just add that inside my knowledge source. And it's a document, txt file. So I'm going to click on document and I'm going to bring the harrypotter.txt here. And click on confirm. And what it's doing, it's basically rendered the harrypotter.txt file. So now let's go back to my workflow. So let's zoom it a little bit. So now here is my question. The question is a chatbot question, how can I help you? And then I'm storing the user query inside this user question. And based on that question is being used to go through my knowledge base, my all knowledge base. Like you see here, already the technical potpourri came, but I'm choosing all knowledge base. And then it's going to give me the answer back. So I want to show the answer here. To showing the answer here, let's bring the text element. And here, the answer will be, turn is an object, and then it will be, let's see the Botpress documentation. So now if you go to the documentation is very good. So I just spent a couple of hours yesterday to go through their documentation, and then I was able to build my own chatbot very quickly. So basically, this is a variable which will store the response coming from the knowledge base. So let's copy that and let's put that here. So what I'm doing, let's review that. So this is my first entry in the chatbot. Chatbot is asking like, how can I help you? And then I'm storing the user input into this variable called user question. And that user question is being used to go through my knowledge base to find out an answer. If there is an answer, I'm typing in the next text element. And this is the variable which stores the answer coming from the knowledge base. So now let's test the chatbot. So now test your bot. Hello, how can I help you? And this time, let me put a question like, who is Harry Potter? And it's searching, and now the response came back. And the good thing is that it came back, and it also showing from where the answer came back. So it's showing the answer is coming from the knowledge base, and this is the Harry Potter. Within a few minutes, I was able to create my chatbot based on my own knowledge base. Now, let's make it a little bit of complex. Let's make it a little bit difficult, okay, or advanced. It's not always possible that my chatbot or my knowledge base have information about everything. That's not possible, right? So what will happen if I ask a question where my knowledge base has no information? For example, let's go here, test your bot again. How can I help you? Let's say I'm typing a question like, tell me about Messi. Definitely, my knowledge base has no information about Messi. My knowledge base holds only about information about Harry Potter. And it came back, no valid answer. So how can I make my chatbot a more intelligent? For example, if there is no answer found from my knowledge base, why don't you go and query ChatGPT or any model to get the answer and print that answer? Can we do that? And the answer is absolutely yes, we can do that. So let's build that intelligent flow here now. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create another node here. And inside this node, in the add cart, I'm going to type AI and I'm going to put AI generated text. And here in the AI generated text, what is my prompt? My prompt is, what is the question that is being asked by my user? And I have already stored that inside a variable called user question. So I'm going to bring that user question here. So that's something I'm going to pass to my AI text. And AI text is going to give me the answer back, which I am going to store inside a variable called, let's say, AI answer. And once the AI answer comes, I want to put that AI answer inside a next variable called, inside a next element called text. And text is going to print the answer coming from this AI text. So for that, it will be AI answer. So it has to be workflow.ai answer. Workflow.ai answer. Similar way, here I need to pass workflow.user question. And then it will be done. No, one more thing. Here in the advanced section, I need to choose which model I want to use to get my answer. So for the timing, I'm choosing GPT, but there are multiple all other models that you can choose, including the DeepSeek. I believe DeepSeek is also here. Yeah, DeepSeek is also here, but you can choose all other models. But for the timing, I'm just going ahead with the default one. So with that, let's delete this one. Let's bring it from here to here and from here to here. So let's review the flow here. Chatbot is initiated. Chatbot is asking like, how can I help you? My user is putting a question. Now the question is being used to search in my own knowledge base. And then if there is answer, it will provide the answer. It will display the answer. Then it will go and search the same thing inside ChatGPT. And whatever the answer comes from ChatGPT, it is going to put it here. And then finishing the flow. So let's test the flow. Asking, test your bot. Let me ask the question. Who is Messi? And it's first searching in my knowledge base. Definitely there is no answer in the knowledge base. It's going to show that there is no answer in the knowledge base. And now the AI task is running, which is this one. And then it's all information came from Messi. Who is Messi and all this thing, right? This information is coming from the ChatGPT. Okay. But do you understand where is the problem? Okay, let me show you the problem. Let's test this flow again. This time, let's ask the question, who is Harry Potter? See what will happen. Okay, I know my knowledge base is already having information about Harry Potter and the answer came back. But now, why, if the answer already came back, why you are searching in the ChatGPT? I don't want that. I want my chatbot to go and search in ChatGPT only if there is no answer coming from my knowledge base. So it should not come here automatically. It should only come when there is nothing is found inside my knowledge base. So let's build that. Let's build that logic. So here, let's put a node. And here, let's put call expression. I don't want to make it always. So let's get rid of this always. And here, let's copy the answer So what I want is that if the knowledge base answer goes to null, means when there is no answer, then, so from here it will come here, it will check, and what it will check is that if my answer is null, which is this, then only go for ChatGPT. But if I already received an answer from my knowledge base, then don't search for ChatGPT, directly go here. So let's review again. This is where the chat initiates and is asking for a question. How can I help you? My user provides a question. The question is being used to search inside my knowledge base. If the answer found, display the answer here. And then here, check whether the answer found inside my own knowledge base. If the answer is found, then end the flow. If the answer not found, then go and search the same query in ChatGPT and bring the answer and then end the flow. Okay, so let's test that. This time, let's start with, tell me about Ronaldo. So definitely no answer found, and now the AI task is running. And very soon it will provide me answer about Ronaldo. It's taking some time because there are so many Ronaldos. I should have given Cristiano Ronaldo. Okay, so it came Cristiano Ronaldo and all the details about Ronaldo. Okay, so let's test the flow one more time. And this time, who is Harry Potter's parent? And I'm expecting the answer coming from my knowledge base, and so it's end the flow. It's not going to fetch the information from ChatGPT because the answer already came from my knowledge base. So it's so easy and so quickly, you can build your own chatbot. As you can see, let's just within 10-15 minutes, I was able to create my own chatbot, including my own knowledge base. And the good thing is that you can publish also. So the moment you click on publish, you'll be given the URL, which you can use inside your website, inside your portal, wherever you want to do that. But yeah, this is the link. So if I open the link in a different tab, look, it looks like my chatbot is ready. Type a message. I'm going to type a message. Who is Harry Potter? And first it will, how can I help you? And now I'm typing, who is Harry Potter? And the answer is directly coming from my own knowledge base, and it's end the flow. So let's test it one more time. Restart. Say hello to initiate the flow. And this time let's ask a question. Who is Sachin Tendulkar? And definitely no answer is found inside my knowledge base. So it will go to the ChatGPT to get the answer and display the answer here. So now it's doing this all the search in ChatGPT, and very soon it's all about Sachin Tendulkar. So as you can see, it's so easy to build your own chatbot, including your own knowledge base. Let me know your use case, your chatbot. I'll be more than happy to go through your chatbot and do some experiment with your chatbot. And if you like this video, please hit the like icon. Please share this with your friends, with your colleagues, so they know how to create chatbot within a very short time. And finally, please subscribe to my channel so that you'll be able to know about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye.